Hi, I'm a big fan. This is a huge honor. We just had Veterans Day a week ago. I know you're so involved with Veterans Affairs.
A lot of people don't know I did 22 years in the military myself. I was in the Marine Corps and the Navy, and I'm involved now. I stay involved. I'm involved in some projects for medical devices that are helping to work with PTSD and traumatic brain injury. And also, I'm a board member of Fisher House, and I am one of those guys with a real big mouth when you mess with my boys.
I know you do. That's why I love you so much. I just wanted to know what you think about versus Obama. How do you think President Trump is doing in supporting our veterans and the military?
It's a holiday season. So in the holiday season, in the spirit of the holidays, you're never supposed to disparage people. Let me just say that I wish we had someone who truly respected the military and not the fact that people have to stand up when he walks in the room. You know, I think the soldiers and sailors, airmen, Marine, Coast Guardmen are getting a little tired of hearing, you know, I love you so much when you do nothing and when you won't take your butt. I spent time in Afghanistan. I did it on my own dime. I got on a plane, I flew to Afghanistan to spend time with troops. There's zero reason why the commander-in-chief, if that's what you think you are, hasn't done the same thing.
How do you feel about the press coverage of President Trump and how the media is treating him and reporting events?
You know, contrary to what some want to fake and believe that all media is fake and all news is fake, I believe that this president has gotten a fair shake. You know, people have reported what he does, and he doesn't like when people tell the truth. That's very clear. So, you know, I hope that our media continues to do their responsible job, their job that was given to them through our Constitution, and that's report the facts and the truth and let that lay where it lays, no matter what anybody complains about it.
So CNN recently said, someone on CNN recently said that they feel that CNN should tape the press conferences ahead of time and edit them to edit Trump's speeches and press conferences.
What do you think? I'll see you, man. Thank
I think
you.
I remember seeing some of that discourse and think that as long as we're reporting news, the news should be reported live. I don't need a filter for me to be able to discern some truth. But if what I'm reporting is nothing more than a political campaign, then I think that you deserve no more time than anybody else. And do what you would do with that if it was anyone else. And that would be edit it and put it in a one segment piece later on. So if you're doing a true news story and the press conference is gonna be news and not some propaganda, then I say run it live and let the truth fall where it falls.
I would love to know what you think about democratic socialism.
I put my hand in the air and swore an oath to the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. And our Constitution was founded on a democracy. Though there's social responsibility in democracy to change the status of who we are as a nation takes a constitutional change, which means that 75% of this nation would be asking for it. Right now, we can't find more than 30% of this nation in any single group, and how dare 30% try to tell the rest of us what we're supposed to be, no matter what that 30% is.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your service, your continued service. It's an honor. Happy holidays.
No, you know, I tell you, one of the things I'm doing in this next year, and your viewers can look out for, I launched two brand new shows. One is called Military Makeover, where we're finding veteran families that are very deserving veteran families, and we're making their homes over from the ground up. And it's been a wonderful experience. First episode airs in November 30th, and then it'll air every Friday after that. And then I've done another show that's called Military Makeover Operation Careers, where we are saluting businesses that are hiring veterans. Because what people have to understand is that, though we know that we have about 10 to 15% of our veterans that are in extremis. They're suffering from post-traumatic stress syndrome. They're suffering from war injuries. But there's 85% of these soldiers who have come home, and all they want to do is be responsible citizens and give back. And we need to give them an opportunity to do that.
Thank you so much. Happy Christmas.